Should the NBA finish this season or at this point just jump right to the playoffs?
Absolutely not. Just jump to the playoffs. They should finish the season. The Lakers right now are 49-14. Last time I checked, 49 plus 14 equals 63. The reality of the situation is that you got about 19 games left in the season. Finish the season. After a month layoff, if not longer, considering the circumstances that nobody could have predicted, the reality is that to just come back and jump into the playoffs, considering the lack of preparation and what have you, lack of practice time, lack of cohesiveness, particularly after you've been playing all season long, and then you take that kind of hiatus, I don't like it at all. It's only 19 games left in the season. Let them finish the season and then take the playoffs well through the month of July, and if possible, right into the first week of August. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. They won't lose any ratings. They won't lose any viewers. It's not like you have to worry about Major League Baseball compromising you in the ratings department in any way. There's absolutely positively no reason to just come out of this hiatus directly and straight into the playoffs. That would be foolish. And then if somebody gets knocked off, they'll have the excuse of rust and lack of preparedness or whatever the case may be to blame. You don't want any excuses. You want to give people at least a little bit of time to get their legs, their bearings under them, and to make sure that this hiccup, this hiatus, isn't something that could be used as an excuse by anybody to compromise their championship aspirations. You come back, you finish the regular season, and you go into the playoffs. I don't give a damn if it goes into August. You do it.
Ideally, you'd like them to finish the season, but Stephen A., the reality is, we go from what's really, really essential, right? What do you want? Do you want something instead of nothing? So here we are at work in different places, right? Because coronavirus is, social distancing. So ideally, of course, I agree with you and you touched on it, but the idea that you're just going to suddenly pick up and there's no time to get your basketball legs underneath you, there's no time to shake the rust off or anything like that, much better if they have a little runway. And if it can't be 19 games, then it could be 15 or 10 or 8 games or 5, something to just get a runway up to the playoffs. But I'll tell you what, brother, if you can't, but you can play the playoffs, play the playoffs. It's going to be an empty gyms as it is. Like this 2-month thing where people are thinking, oh, it's good. Who says it's going to be 2 months? It's likely, say many, to be longer than that, right? Because we were told not long ago, a week ago, the highest levels of this government, there are plenty of tests for everyone. There are no tests for anyone practically. So unless those tests become readily available to many more people, they're not going to be even able to play games in the next month or two. Never mind whether the virus is actually contained to the point where people can resume life as normal. Remember what I said about those studies about the flu in 1918. The key factors for good outcomes in various cities, the ones who fared well, it wasn't about the size of the city or even the population density so much as it was about early action. We missed the boat on that. And also the duration of that action. So just today across the country in many cities from New York to L.A., in the last 24 hours, bars and restaurants are closed. Public spaces are closing. I mean, this is going to get worse before it gets better. The reason I bring that all up, Stephen A., is because in a perfect world, hell yeah, I want to see the regular season played out for every single reason you mentioned. But I will certainly take, if this is the realistic option, a playoffs with no more regular season in empty gyms. Like, I'll take it, man. That's better than nothing.
Well, nobody is saying, Max, don't have the playoffs unless you can finish the regular season. We're talking about what our preference is here. Let me be very, very clear about where I stand. I am not saying that, it's finished the regular season or else. Of course, under dire circumstances, if you have to go into the playoffs, you do that. But in terms of following their projection, we might not be back until mid-June. I'm like, damn it, so what? Then you know what? Finish the regular season and go into August. Now, you don't want to go into September.
That's
I'll
the
give
problem.
You that. You certainly don't want. You don't want a scenario or a situation where you're ending up going into the football season. That is the only condition that should stop and halt any kind of thing where we're saying don't finish the regular season or whatever. But anything that has you finishing the playoffs before September, you do it. Period. Even if it's in the August, even if it's in the preseason football,
I'm with that.
It doesn't matter. As long as it doesn't interfere with the regular season of the NFL, because there's no way you're going to compete with that. As long as that is not your that is not your competition, look, you go for it.
In order, the hierarchy, which probably reflects popular culture in the United States now, is the NFL seems to be the league best positioned that this will affect them the least. And part of that is timing, which is just good luck. And part of them is the strength. Part of that is the strength of the league domestically. Then the NBA, then Major League Baseball. Major League Baseball is in trouble, right? And not enough people seem to care, and that's one of the reasons it's in trouble. The NBA, though, Stephen A., we agree about this, right? Like, of course, it could push it as far as the regular season in football, even through preseason in football. But try this one. Let's say the circumstances are more dire than are being hoped for now, which is a distinct possibility. And the NBA has to put everything on pause, cancel the regular season, empty gyms, and play during the regular season in football. My point is I want to see an NBA playoffs no matter what.
Look, man, listen, they joke around, particularly with trades and guys that can't play, calling me the Grim Reaper. Could you calm down, please? Can we be a little bit optimistic just for all of us and the American people? Can we do that? Can we sit up here? If they sat up there and said, excuse me, we're projecting that we may be back in mid-June, can we hold on to that, please, as opposed to painting this picture that it could be worse? I'm thinking optimistically. I believe in us as Americans. I believe in this nation. I believe in this country.
Stephen
I believe
A.
in this world. Somehow, some way, better times
wishful
are ahead.
Thinking.
Can we be a bit optimistic,
wishful,
my brother?
Wow.
Can we do that?
I understand that sentiment, but wishful thinking instead of realistic thinking has exacerbated this situation.
How do you
so
know what realistic thinking is?
So let's hope for the best, but prepare for the worst.